Right. Welcome to my documentary. That's wrong. I don't know if this is a documentary. Fuck. In the year 2017, I traveled the world. I took a camera on a phone camera thing, and filmed everything I did like an extremely creepy person. I'm not sure why you would want to watch that, but this is that story. And it's, fuck, let's just start. So the story begins here. I've just shot my Netflix special. I'm taking a bow. The audience seems to have liked it. But what am I actually thinking about? I have this thought. I want to do a world tour. Like a legitimate world tour. Problem is, you know, world tours are done by huge comics, guys who look like this. Or this, or this. Not guys who look like this. So I have this trick, right? Whenever I'm not sure if I can actually do something, I manipulate myself into doing it. So I always design the poster first and put the poster out. Because once it's out, I have to do it. So we shoot a promo for a tour that doesn't exist yet. Little bit of PR and we're on our way.
Haven't been here for a while.
Sold out.
Can see your face light up as the cold came down.
The show sucks. Donkey balls. I mean, there's material, but it's not a show. It's nothing. You know, the audience had a good time, sure, but in your heart, you know, it's like, it's a 6/10 show. I realize I put so much into this Netflix material, maybe I've got nothing to say. And I'm headlining all of these shows, and it feels in my heart like I'm cheating people. I'm not ready. So now I'm officially panicked. I canceled 2 weekends of shows just so I can sit in LA and write a little bit. This, by the way, is my favorite place to write in LA. I go here every day for 2 weeks. And I get on stage anywhere I can, just set up spots. Because next week is Atlanta. So Desi people are showing up to this diner, just thinking, his career's not going very well, is it? So when you suddenly take the pressure off and you're trying to write desperately, there's one thing that suddenly unlocks everything, right? For me, that was a bit about putting nipples on bums. This is the shit I think about at night. So armed with new jokes about bum udders, we go to New York City. New York. New York. New York. Or as Indians call it, too expensive. Let's go to Jersey. And no, I'm not playing Madison Square Garden. I'm playing someplace much scarier. Caroline's on Broadway. A proper NYC comedy club.
Sold out. Sold out.
You know, go do a show, go get some food, go see some art, go see some shows, meet some friends. I don't know how, I don't know why, but something starts to work in New York.
Badi thand hai, ghar ki yaad aa gayi.
And I suddenly feel a little confident, right? Because hey, if New York is laughing, then there must be something to laugh at. Maybe I should stop doubting myself. I leave New York with a hangover and a sense of starting to see the light. I'm flowing. That's how I can describe it. Flow. Until April 25th, when my world and my flow got fucking turned upside down.
My name is Veer Das. I'm from Bombay in India. Has anybody ever been to India? Well, if you haven't been, you must go because your jobs have.
Fantastic! That was fantastic! Veer Das, ladies and gentlemen!
Well, I know I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you.
I can't even. So in 1 week, your life changes. You're suddenly getting messages from every country in the world, and somebody you've idolized for 20 years gives you a call and wants to work with you. And you don't have a second to enjoy that shit that happened because you're on a flight. You're on tour. You know what's great about Sydney? Sydney looks like every single postcard you have ever seen of Sydney. Exactly. It's like meeting a really hot actress and going, huh, correct.
Boarding Das tour, I'm on tour right now. I'm on top of the Sydney Harbour Bridge.
I have to confess, I like Melbourne more. Melbourne is lovely. It's like Sydney and New York had sex while San Francisco was wearing direction. And then the tour really gets rolling. Cities start to blend into one another.
I have to go to morning radio to promote the shows. When I'm lonely, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's lonely without you. And when I'm dreaming, well, I know I'm gonna dream about the time when I'm with you. When I go out,
every show is sold out.
They sold out too fast. I mean, I'm not complaining, but it's like this tour finally has momentum. Or nipples, I'm not sure, on its bum. Either way, it's moving. You ever see yourself on a poster with people you clearly don't deserve to be on a poster with? That's what this whole year felt like. Oh, and speaking of being undeserving, it was time for a show in Los Angeles. On hallowed ground.
So this is the Hollywood Improv. And that piano back there, pretty much every great comedian in the world has performed in front of. And that shall be unknown tonight when I perform.
Fun fact, Just for Laughs is the best comedy festival in the world. It's like Disneyland for comics. It's the one you dream of doing. And if you look at their lineup, okay, look a little bit closer. A little closer, like way close. There we are, there we are. Yeah, I got to go to Disneyland. Just look at that lineup. Just look at it. I want the autograph of every person on that lineup. I think that's what should be next to my name. Just Veer Das brackets looking for autographs. It's insane. And it was about to get even more insane. Scotland was this much needed break because 1 week from Scotland I had my biggest, scariest, most nerve-wracking gig. Was I ready for London?
Okay, it is 5:30 PM. I've just gotten into the taxi. We are going to the O2 Forum. It's my best friend Sahil. Sahil, say hello.
Hello.
There's a moment before every single show. It's my favorite moment. It's when you're walking through whatever backstage tunnel or kitchen or back entrance or whatever, and when you go to the O2 Forum in London, before the battle even begins, that venue kicks your ass.
So, I'm gonna go throw up about 7 times.
I'm so fucking nervous. Oh shit, you thought we were done, didn't you? No.